Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and if you're new here, welcome to my channel. I'm a firm believer that everyone has an interesting story to tell, and I'm here to help you with a visual aspect of it by helping you make better videos. Today, we're going to learn how to add the animated split screen effect seen at the start of this video. If you subscribe to my channel, there's a good chance you know that I did a similar video last summer. People really seemed to enjoy it, but I only showed how to add the split screen effect. I got a ton of comments asking for a follow-up video to show you how I animated my clips onto the screen. So this time around, besides showing you how to add the split screen effect, I'll show you how you can animate it at the same time. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and get started. Select your first clip and drop it down into your timeline. The way we achieve the split screen effect is by using the crop tool. You could just crop the clip itself, but I strongly recommend using an adjustment layer. I'll show you why in a bit. For now, if you don't have an adjustment layer, click the link in the video description to go to my website and download one for free. Once the adjustment layer is installed, select it in your titles browser and add it above your clip. Ripple trim it to the same length as your clip. Move your playhead to where you want your second clip to come in, and with the adjustment layer clip selected, select the crop tool and add a keyframe. Move your playhead about 20 frames ahead and use the crop controls in the inspector to crop off the right half of your clip. My project is HD, so 1920 pixels wide. To crop off half of that, click on the number beside the right slider and enter half of 1920, which is 960. Click Done. Using the crop tool on the adjustment layer instead of the clip itself allows us to reframe the clip inside this half of the split screen window. First, with the adjustment layer clip selected, press Ctrl-V to bring up the video animation menu to see where your keyframes are. Place your playhead on the first set of keyframes, select the video clip, switch to the Transform tool, and add a keyframe. Move to your second set of keyframes, and use the on-screen controls to reframe your clip. Right-click on each control point in the viewer, and switch the movement type from Smooth to Linear. Here's what we have so far. Before adding the second clip, move your playhead to the first set of keyframes, command-click both clips to select them, and combine them into a compound clip with a keyboard shortcut Option-G. With your playhead still in the same spot, select your second clip and add it to your timeline. Add an adjustment layer above this clip and ripple trim it to the same length as your clip. Move your playhead to the start of the set of clips, select the adjustment layer, and bring up the crop tool. This clip will come in from the right, so to start, we want to crop off the entire clip. If your project is HD, type in 1920 for the left crop value. Add a keyframe here. Move your playhead 20 frames ahead, and set the left crop value to half that again, which is 960. Select your video clip, and use the Transform tool to reframe it. We don't have to worry about any keyframes here. Click Done, and combine these two into a compound clip to reveal the clip underneath. Move your playhead to where you want your following clip to come in, add your clip to your timeline, and add an adjustment layer above it. This one here will have come in from the top, so select your adjustment layer and crop off the entire clip from the bottom. Add a keyframe. Move your playhead 20 frames ahead and set your bottom crop value to half of your vertical resolution, so in our case, 540. Combine these two into a compound clip. To compensate for a top clip, we now need to adjust the crop amount and the framing of our bottom clips. Set your playhead at the start of your top clip and double-click on the bottom compound clip to go into it. Without moving the playhead, select the adjustment layer and add a keyframe to all your crop parameters. Select your video clip and add keyframes to all your transform parameters. Hold down the Shift key and press the right arrow key twice to move your playhead forward 20 frames. With the adjustment layer clip selected, crop off the top half of your clip. Select your video clip and use the transform tool to resize and reframe your video clip. Right-click on each control point in the viewer, and once again, switch the motion type to linear. Click Done, and press the back arrow key under the viewer window to go back to your timeline. Move your playhead back to the start of your top clip, and repeat the same steps for your middle clip. Here's what we have so far. Next, we're going to add some borders between our clips to separate them, but before we do, I'd like to take a minute to talk about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Envato Elements is a must-have subscription service for any type of creator. For a low monthly fee, you get unlimited downloads of stock footage, royalty-free music and sound effects, graphic templates, video templates, and so much more. Whether you're making YouTube videos, podcasts, designing websites, or any type of creative work, Envato Elements is guaranteed to have something to improve your next project. For example, in this video, all these beautiful demo clips, the background music, and all the sound effects were all downloaded from Envato Elements, all for one low monthly fee. And if you get an annual subscription, you can have everything Envato Elements has to offer for half price. Trust me, it's worth it. Now, back to Final Cut Pro. To add a bit of separation between the clips in our split screen effect, we can use the crop tool to add dividers between our clips and a border around the entire image. First, let's animate in a border around our image. Double click the bottom clip to go into the compound clip. Select the adjustment layer and press Ctrl V to show where your keyframes are. Move your playhead to the first keyframe, hold down the Shift key, and press the left arrow key to go back 10 frames. Select the crop tool and add a keyframe here. Move your playhead ahead 10 frames and crop each side of your image by 30 pixels to add a border all the way around your frame. Move your playhead to the next keyframe and change the left, top, and bottom crop values to 30 again. The right crop parameter, the one we use for our split screen effect, is slightly different. Since this is a divider between the two clips, we only need half the width of our border, which is 15. Take the number you have here and add another 15 pixels to it. Repeat these steps for the rest of your keyframes, cropping the outside edges of your clip by 30 pixels and the edges between clips by 15. Click done and go back to your timeline. Double click your next clip to go into your compound clip and repeat the same steps. Select the adjustment layer, Ctrl V to show your video animation keyframes, and change your right, top, and bottom crop values to 30. Move to the next keyframe, change the outside crop edge values to 30, and add 15 to the edges between clips. Repeat this for all your keyframes and do the same to your top clip. And last, since these borders and dividers are transparent, if you want a different color, all you need to do is go to your generator's browser, select the solids category, and add a custom generator under your timeline. Ripple trim it so it's the same length as your clips, and change the color of it in a generator's inspector. Here's our finished result. I only used 3 clips for this demo, but you can keep going and add as many clips as you need using the same steps. Just have to do a little bit of math for the crop values. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.